This episode of Tekzilla is sponsored by Citrix ShareFile.
Thermal cameras, I've been in love with them ever since we installed a Pathfinder on my truck in an episode of System. Night vision is cool, but traditionally it's really expensive. What we're talking about here is a microbolometer, thermal sensing. Seriously, this is expensive. That Pathfinder we installed on my truck was $2,500 just for the parts.
Whoa.
It's easy to spend over $1,000 on a thermal camera on eBay, used and beat to hell because an HVAC contractor ran around with it for a couple of years. Enter Seek's thermal camera. If you go to thermal.com, you can pick up a Seek thermal camera for Android or iPhone for $199. Check this out. So this is the actual camera itself. It's a dongle that plugs into iPhone or Android. It's $199. The iOS Lightning adapter or microUSB for Android 4.4.2 and up. Seek worked with Raytheon and Freescale Semiconductor to develop the sensor. And what you're looking at right now is not very interesting until, ladies
Here
and gentlemen,
Hi.
Shannon walks in. So this is a true thermal sensor, long wave infrared, 7.2 to 13 microns, vanadium oxide, microbolometer, 12 micrometer pixel pitch, if I'm reading that correctly, 206 by 156 resolution. It's like 32,000 thermal pixels, which sounds like nothing compared to what we're used to, but it is actually not bad for a thermal camera. What we're looking at right here is there's all sorts of different color modes you can select to look for what gives you the best image.
I look like a scary ghost.
You do look like a scary ghost. You can use it to take temperature. They say it's accurate within a degree. Notice how if I go to the wall, it's 78. Shannon's like 94. Shannon's hair is like 83 degrees. They have a high-low that's not quite working. The software is very beta. I guarantee you Shannon is not 118 degrees. So this is an example, like what you're looking at right now on your screen is an example of a black room. There is no light that we can actually see in there except for a couple of LEDs in the back. And if you look at that, you'll see the glow from the LED, and then you can actually see Michael in the back of the room.
Ooh.
I used it to see a cat in the backyard looking at the temperature, basically to measure the temperature of the exhaust manifold of my vehicle. Seek's really excited because they don't exactly know what people are going to use it for, right? Mm.
Shannon? I know what I'm going to use it for.
What are you going to use
ghost it for? Ghost hunting.
Ghost hunting.
Yes! I'm totally going to take this with me ghost hunting so I can find out where the ghosts are coming up into the room.
You believe in ghosts?
Maybe.
We need to talk later on. It's pretty durably built, magnesium housing. The next cheapest thermal camera out there is the FlirONE. We talked about it at CES. It's iPhone only. It's $350. And like I mentioned, that's down from $1,000 to thousands of dollars for traditional thermal cameras. Cons right now, software's still evolving, but it's evolving fast. The dongle faces the wrong way on the Nexus 5, as in you end up sort of taking selfies with the thermal camera because of the way the micro-USB port faces on the Nexus 5. We hear that's a problem with the HTC 1 also. I would like more resolution, but the reality is that 32,000 pixels, which sounds like nothing compared to a digital camera, is actually not bad for a thermal imaging device. I'm really actually kind of amazed by this. I'm also a kind of a thermal imaging geek, and I can't wait to see if I can figure out how to remote mount this. Did I mention magnesium housing being tough? Remote mount this on my vehicle via USB cable to see if I can do the forward viewing stuff in the car.
Oh, so fun.
Resolution's a little low for that, but it's fun to play around with. So thermal.com is the website. $199 is the price. Lightning or iOS 4.4.2 and higher on Android.
I love it. So, super fun. Can I borrow it? Yes.
Can I have it back now?
Nope.
Uh-huh. We'll talk about that later. Coming up next, we got a viewer question. But first, let's take a moment to thank one of our sponsors.
The constant flow of information is crucial to business. You have contracts, spreadsheets, invoices, and other important business files that are sent as regular email attachments with no reliable means to ensure that they've been received or reviewed. You lose control the moment you hit send, and that's why you need Citrix's ShareFile. It's the easy-to-use business solution for sending, receiving, and sharing files. With ShareFile, your attachments are sent as secure links. You can send files of almost any size without bounce backs, and they are always under your control, so you decide who has access to your files and for how long. You receive notifications telling you who opens your files and when. And plus, you can password protect files for optimal security. Then you can easily share files and collaborate with others. And ShareFile mobile apps allow you to access your files anytime, anywhere. So sign up today for our 30-day free trial with no obligation. Go to ShareFile.com, click the microphone at the top of the homepage, and enter Tekzilla. Remember, visit ShareFile.com and type in Tekzilla.